Chichiko Ancient Town in Chongqing.
Is the Kwanjai Alley from Chengdu.
I think what I love most about Chongqing is just living in a mountain city. You have beauty surrounded by you. You have lots of mountains and trails and hiking, and I like being able to go biking on the river on my weekends. But you know, with all that said, the food is probably my most favorite part. You can have amazing food from different parts of Sichuan, from Guizhou, and also Chongqing, and having that just makes life so much more interesting.
Chongqing is the capital of famous delicacies in China. So to continue our series on why people love Chongqing, we have come to the food streets of Jiefanbei to come and try out the range of tasty snacks on offer. So now I've hopefully managed to whet your appetite. Let's go and take a look around. Let's give it a taste. Very hot and spicy. And of course, Chongqing is very famous for the spicy food, so when you come try the snacks here, you often find they'll have a lot of chili powder, also mixed with the powder from the prickly ash, and lots of other spices as well. I would have to say this is very tasty. And the good thing is we have lots of stalls here to choose from, so you don't just have to eat one thing when you come here, you can eat lots of different things as well. As you can see from this queue behind me, the stall here is doing really brisk business, but it was worth the wait, and I finally managed to buy myself a couple of spicy fried chicken cartilage. So the Jiefanbei food street is so popular that it has exploded in scale over the past years. In the beginning there was only one food street, but now there's a second, and also there's third street where I'm standing right now. So let's give these a try. Yeah, these are delicious. This is the quintessential dish of Chongqing, hot pots. And when people all over China think of hot pots, they think of Chongqing. In the early days, it was invented by local porters on the dockside, but now restaurants can use it to cook all kinds of dishes. Over here, we have a bowl of tripe, and here we have another specialty that people love here, and that's duck intestines. So I'm going to show you how this works. I'm going to take a slice of tripe and I'm going to swirl it in the soup for about 10 to 15 seconds. And you know, a lot of people say this red spicy soup of hot pot is representative of the people of Chongqing because they are well known for being kind and hospitable. Okay, so now this is about ready. I'm going to put this in a bowl of condiments, and when I'm ready, I can start eating it. So next time you come to Chongqing, don't forget, hot pot is one of the dishes that you must try. Okay, so good evening.
Good evening.
So first of all, could you introduce yourself for us?
So my name is Nicholas. I'm from France. I'm 34 years old. I come to China like 8 years ago now, and I moved myself to Chengdu 4 years ago. So now I'm living in Chengdu and Chongqing for 4 years.
I see. And why did you choose to open a bar here on 9th Street in Chongqing?
So I'm also a partner of Revolution Cocktail. It's a club we have in 9th Street also. And for me, the best place, the best entertaining place in Chongqing, it has to be in 9th Street. So that's why I decided to open another bar here in Chongqing.
Okay, and do you like Chongqing as a city?
I love Chongqing, I love Chengdu, both of them. It's I keep going back, and it's always a pleasure to travel between those two cities here.
So what is it you like most about Chongqing?
I cannot say hot pot, but I try to get myself used to it, but I love the people, I love the vibe. It's a very crowded city, and every time you can just take 20 minute taxi and just discover again the city, because it's huge, it's a huge city. So you cannot get bored of this city.
So you've also spent a lot of time living in Chengdu.
Yeah.
So now you've opened a bar in Chongqing. What do you think are the main differences between the two cities?
I would say, no offense, but Chengdu is more developed. But Chongqing, it's a place to develop something. So it's like more and more foreigner restaurant coming up, new different clubs, new different entertaining place, coffee shop, fancy one. So it's definitely going to be crazy the next 3 or 4 years for sure.
We're in a bar called Bamboo on 9th Street, which is a nightlife hotspot here in Chongqing. And whether it's restaurants, bars, or karaoke clubs you're looking for, the street that never sleeps is always packed full of them. Now, since the epidemic has been brought under control, the vibrant atmosphere of 9th Street has returned to how it was before. So don't forget, in Chongqing, we have great snacks, we have hot pot, and we also have vibrant nightlife. So wherever you are in the world, we hope that one day in the near future, you get a chance to come to Chongqing and experience this for yourself.
CRI Türk. İyi müzik, doğru haber.